But tonight, our top story. The showdown between the Narendra Modi government and the opposition is worsening by the day. Visuals of yesterday's proceedings in the Rajya Sabha, where there was bedlam, are now out. The footage shows opposition MPs jostling with marshals. The opposition claims they were the ones who were manhandled. The government says it is the opposition MPs who assaulted the marshals. All said there is only one loser in this fight: the Indian democracy, the Indian voter, and yes, you, the taxpayer. Let's just take a look at exactly what is happening in our parliament, which has turned into an akhada.
Rajya Sabha turns into a battle zone. The passage of a hotly contested bill that allows the government to sell its stake in general insurance companies triggers a full-fledged face-off. The opposition MPs rush to the well, demanding that the bill be sent to the select committee, even as marshals form a shield cordoning them off.
Subject to correction, ayes 187, noes nil.
While the bill is passed amidst the din, what happened on Wednesday has brought shame to India's temple of democracy. In videos released by official sources, on Thursday, opposition MPs can be seen jostling a woman marshal. The opposition alleges the marshal called in by the speaker manhandled them. The battle that began inside parliament is now being fought outside. First, the opposition MPs turned out in big numbers to stage protests.
Honorable Minister for Information and Broadcasting.
Then the government fielded seven ministers to counter the opposition charges. The two sides also met the Rajya Sabha chairperson Venkaiah Naidu separately to raise their concerns about what happened in the house.
इतना फोर्स तो मैंने कभी मार्शल का देखा नहीं है और वो पहले से मौजूद थे तो इसका मतलब ये कि आप बोलने ही नहीं दोगे और पहले से फोर्स इन द अपर हाउस राज्यसभा में फोर्स लाने की कहां जरूरत है ये तो डिबेट और डिस्कशन का विषय है तो इतना सारा फोर्स मैंने भी आज तक कभी नहीं देखा
दिस इज अ क्लियर साइन कि विपक्ष इज ट्राइंग टू प्रीएम्प्ट एनी एक्शन बिकॉज ऑफ देयर मिसकंडक्ट अनरूली बिहेवियर एंड The threatening approach of the opposition. It was a shameful disgrace in the parliamentary history of India.
The MPs in the eye of the storm, Chaya Verma, who is accused of assaulting the woman marshal, is crying victim.
पूरे भारत के इतिहास में आप देखेंगे कि ऐसा सदन कभी नहीं चला होगा पूरी एक तरह से उनकी पूरी मनमानी चल रही है पूरे डेमोक्रेसी का मर्डर हो रहा है जिस बात को सदन के अंदर रखना चाहते हैं उनको रखने नहीं दिया जा रहा है और अपने हिसाब से वो सदन चलाना चाहते हैं
द अनप्रेसिडेंटेड सीन्स इन राज्यसभा वेयर अ कल्मिनेशन ऑफ अ फायरी मॉनसून सेशन दैट सॉ नियरली जीरो डिबेट on key issues like price rise, farm laws, and Pegasus hacking scandal. This, even as many bills were rushed through.
There has been no parliament session because the voice of 60% of this country has been crushed, humiliated, and yesterday in the Rajya Sabha, physically beaten. This is nothing short of the murder of the democracy of this country.
उन्होंने क्या क्या किया उन पार्टी ने क्या किया लोकसभा में राज्यसभा में कैसे उनका व्यवहार था ये सब देश देख रही है I demand if they have sense, little sense of responsibility and democracy, they should apologize to the country.
The opposition leaders marched for about a mile. The distance may have been short, but it managed to make just the right noise and rattle the government. The long march, though, towards 2024 is going to be a tough one, as the road ahead is bumpier for the opposition. With camera person Sanjay Kumar, this is Anand Patel for India Today.
Let's go straight across to my first newsmaker tonight. Joining me now is the country's Parliamentary Affairs Minister, Prahlad Joshi, the man in the hotspot. Mr. Joshi, appreciate your joining us. An entire parliamentary session virtually washed out. Who is going to take responsibility for what seems to be a complete breakdown between the government and the opposition? As Parliamentary Affairs Minister, doesn't the buck stop with you, sir?
No. What I can tell you, basically, they tried to, it was their pre-decision, they pre-decided that this particular session should not run, it should be washed out. But in spite of all those things, we were under the compulsion to pass the bills. Mm-hmm. And we have passed around 21, 22 bills which were in the interest of the people.
I'll come to the passage of bills in a moment, but the fact is I want to first focus on these almost unprecedented and terrifying images that we are showing on the screen at the moment that are dominating the headlines. The manner in which the Rajya Sabha yesterday saw pandemonium, the scenes that we have seen. As a taxpayer, sir, you know, parliament costs 2.5 lakhs a minute. Makes me wonder, why do we have a parliament? The government blames the opposition for manhandling a lady marshal. The opposition says its women MPs were manhandled. You say bills are passed, but it is these scenes, sir, that I want an explanation for. What explains what is happening, sir?
Rajdeep, can you believe people outside the parliament premises, they are not able to say anything, or they are not able to raise their hand on the MPs? Can you imagine where entire thing is recorded? Any ordinary employee, he is a class 3 or class 2 employee. Mm-hmm. Can you imagine that they do something to the MPs, that is to in the premises where they have privileges? Can you imagine this? And everything is recorded. If anybody investigates tomorrow, he knows, the employee will be knowing, and he will always be aware what is going to happen to them. Can you imagine this? And have you not seen the footage which has come out?
Sir, that's the foot.
It is not that government is blaming. It is.
No, sir, I have seen that footage. This footage is playing on air of what happened yesterday. The opposition is accusing the government of leaking the 2 to 3 minutes of footage selectively, not showing the entire footage of what happened yesterday. Let's be very clear, sir. Give us a clear explanation in your view what happened yesterday. Who is responsible?
No, it is entirely wrong. I can challenge this. It is entirely wrong to say it is a false allegation. Mm-hmm. Whatever it has appeared in the whatever they have done, that can only appear. No, either it is male marshal or female marshal, they can dare to do anything to MP. You please try to understand, this is a democratic state, and that is true. When they have got so much privileges and everything is recorded, can you imagine this? See, what they say, it cannot be, we cannot discuss on that, because it's everything. And what they did on 9th, table is for the writing, or table is for the dancing in the Lok Sabha or Rajya Sabha? What they did when they tried to forcibly enter the chamber, which was closed on 4th of August? See, don't try to jump the conclusion on the false allegation. I would like to complete. Anybody can come and see.
Yes, go ahead, Mr. Joshi.
Anybody can come and see entire footage. We don't have any objection. Let me make it very clear. And it will be in the control of either government. It will be under the control of either speaker or chairman of the Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. Let them understand that. And nobody can dare to do that.
No, sir, I'm only telling you, opposition claiming that the video was selectively leaked. And not only, sir, or even someone as senior, or probably the senior most MP today, Sharad Pawar, saying that in the 55 years of his parliamentary history, or in his legislative history, and these are his words, sir, in my 55 years of parliamentary career, I never saw the way the women MPs were attacked today. More than 40 men and women were brought into the house from outside. It is painful. It is an attack on democracy. This is Sharad Pawar, sir, saying, claiming that the women MPs were manhandled. Your response?
No, I have seen his statement. He is misinformed. That much only I can say. I have got a lot of respect and regards about Shri Sharad Pawarji, and he is quite senior also. I got lot of regards for him, but he is misinformed. and no marshal has in any way manhandled anybody. Mm-hmm. In fact, these few MPs, they have tried to manhandle female MP. This is most unfortunate. This is available on footage.
Okay, you're making a very serious charge. You're saying that, you know, what has happened in Parliament involves the marshals have unfortunately been made the villains. They were only caught in the crossfire. You know, beyond this, though, beyond these scenes, because this tutu meh-meh, sir, will go on endlessly, is the question as a taxpayer. We have seen, Mr. Joshi, an entire session now virtually wasted. You are saying that bills are passed, but the charge is these bills are being passed without any scrutiny. The average time spent on a bill in Parliament now is barely 34 minutes. Many of these bills are serious ones. They're not even sent for scrutiny to a select or standing committee. Opposition says only 11% of the bills now are sent for scrutiny. Earlier it was 74%. The accusation, sir, is the government is running Parliament like as if it is a cabinet meeting where you come and the opposition has no role, no response. All the government does is stamp a bill and it goes ahead.
What can I say to Rajiv to you? You can ask this question to them. We requested on daily basis. Today we are bringing this bill and it was circulated well in advance. We requested them to participate. I have spoken to them many times. PUG has spoken to them many times. And Sri Rajnath Singh Ji has spoken to them many times. Amit Shah Ji has spoken to them. After repeatedly requesting on the floor of the house, if they don't participate in the debate, is it the mistake of the government? And we tried heaven and earth to bring on the negotiation table. And we requested them participate in the debate. Ultimately, Parliament is for the legislation, mm-hmm. discussion.
Yes.
And if they don't want to do that, and what can you... No, 1 minute. I would like to ask, sir, you one question. What happened on 9th? You just give me one minute.
Yes.
On 9th, what happened? Are you going to endorse it? 9th, they danced on the table. And that person who danced on the table, they are coming outside and saying, I am ready to do it 100 times even in future.
Mr. Joshi.
Are you going to endorse this?
No, I don't, sir. Mr. Joshi.
Elder's house.
Sir, Mr. Joshi, who's endorsing what Mr. Bajwa has done? In fact, I had him on my show 2 nights ago. No one endorses what someone like Mr. Bajwa, the Congress MP, does by standing on a table and throwing a file. What he did was wrong. My point is, what are you going to do about it? And why have matters reached such a stage? Are you going to take an action against him? Are you going to ask for a full inquiry? Mr. Bajwa says the government doesn't allow the opposition to speak. You say that he has misbehaved and therefore there should be action. I come back to it, sir. MPs are being paid out of taxpayers' money to raise our issues in Parliament. At the moment, the fact is, sir, that is not happening.
I fully agree with you. I appreciate your concern. I appreciate whatever you have raised your voice. And we have already requested Honorable Chairman to entirely, in totally inquire into it and take an exemplary action against them.
So the one question though is that the opposition, as I said, is saying the government is not even ready to have their voice heard. They don't want a discussion, for example, on Pegasus, which the opposition wanted. They are saying that the government stalled the issue of Pegasus. That is why the entire session is being washed out. I want to ask you, what stopped your government from having a proper debate on a serious issue like Pegasus? Was that the reason that resulted in this breakdown?
That is the only bahana. They are trying to make just a cause to wash out. Wash out when from the day one itself, they are hinting, and some of them, they have given statement. Even in BAC, one of the major political parties leader, he has told that you may agree for anything. They ask for price rise, economic situation, price rise, we agreed. Mm-hmm. They ask for COVID, we agreed. They ask for farmers, we agreed. And after that, they said Pegasus, and Pegasus, we made a statement, Suomoto statement was made.
Mm-hmm.
And when IT minister was making statement, his paper was snatched and it was torn off and thrown on the chair. And repeatedly chairman, sir, told that you can ask clarification. Even after 2 days, mm-hmm. chairman called us and said, at the time of the statement, they have asked the clarification. Are you now ready to give a clarification? They said, We said we are ready. Whenever you fix the time, we are ready for any clarification, for the discussion, we are ready. And they did not, they are not ready for to ask the even clarification. Is it our mistake?
Sir, my point is, from the outside, let me again say, it seems like there is a complete breakdown in trust between the government and the opposition. The opposition claims that Mr. Modi's government wants to run the parliament the way it wants to push through any bill it decides, not send any bill to any scrutiny. You, on the other hand, seem to believe that the parliament, that the opposition is obstructionist, only wants to, in a way, get its my way or the highway. Now, how long is this going to continue if both sides accuse each other in this manner? I mean, you know, if the opposition accuses you of running parliament like a big boss house, and you say that the opposition is the one responsible for this bad behavior, how is the basic trust in parliament going to be restored, sir, between the two sides?
No, we are talking on day-to-day basis. Rajdeep, please try to understand. Narendra Modi government doesn't want to run like this, and we want discussion, we want constructive suggestion, and whatever they have asked, we agreed for their discussion. And we could have passed the why did they oblige to on OBC constitutional amendment bill? They said we are ready to discuss. We said actually it was decided for 3 hours, and they said then 5 hours, then it went up to 6 hours. We have cooperated, we want discussion. And even other day, that is yesterday, I told them, if you can discuss and oppose the bill, I am ready to take it on Thursday, I am ready to take it on Friday, even if you want, I am ready to take it on Monday. Only you assure me that you will discuss and dispose it off. If you want oppose, you have got all right to oppose. If you want to give constructive suggestion, you can give the suggestion. Government is open. And what happened from the day one, when Prime Minister wanted to introduce his Council of Minister, he was not allowed. Is it the democracy we are talking?
Sir, you know, in a democracy also, sir, Parliament is supposed to legislate. The legislation takes place through a committee system. The question which is repeatedly being asked is the Modi government willing to send any bill to any committee for scrutiny? According to the opposition, what is happening in Parliament is the Gujarat model. In Gujarat, when Prime Minister Modi was Chief Minister, the accusation was he would not allow bills to be debated or discussed or sent to committees. Let's get this straight, sir. You know, how long is this going to continue in a manner in which each of you accuse each other without proper legislative practices?
Sir, many bills have been discussed, sent to the Parliamentary Standing Committee, and even if they discuss, they properly discuss, if they come for the discussion, if they come for the suggestion, then government is open. Before coming to Parliament, before introducing it, before consideration could start, you send to the, we don't want to any debate, we don't want debate on anything, any bill which is non-contentious, that bill also we don't want to discuss, you send some bill to the standing committee. Is this the attitude?
Sir,
you don't want to discuss, you don't want to debate, you don't want to suggest, and then you are just telling that you send it to the some parliament. And
sir, Mr. Joshi, with due regard, sir, you know, let me ask you this. Between now and the winter session, there are about 4 months. I want to get clarity, and I'm asking this not just today as a journalist but a tax-paying citizen. I'm paying taxes for what's going on in Parliament. We are paying your salaries, sir. Will you all make an effort first to ensure there is a full inquiry into all that has happened in this session? Those who are responsible for the bedlam, will action be taken against them? And are you also going to call for a change in rules so that you don't have these disruptions? And will we see a genuine reach out between the government and the opposition so that next time Parliament can take place in a better atmosphere where actually a debate and dialogue takes place, sir?
No, definitely we will request, we will put all the best efforts to see that inquiry is done, and people who have misbehaved, in spite of having knowledge about the rule and this, all these precedences, people who have misbehaved, they should be punished. And also I would like to clarify you, Rajdeep ji, and other leaders, senior leaders, and there are good sensible leaders, I will personally go and meet them and request them, whoever has misbehaved, there will be a inquiry and we will fix them. But remaining people, we want to talk them, we want to hear them, and we want that under the Modi ji's leadership, we want that there should be discussion and dialogue should continue, and I will do that.
Okay, that's reassuring to hear that you are ready to reach out to the opposition even now and try and find a way out of this situation that we see unfolding before us. Appreciate your joining us, Mr. Minister Prahlad Joshi, Parliamentary Affairs Minister.